regular season championship.
The momentum would carry over into the Frontier Conference playoffs with a home win against Northern Montana College 72-56.
Our score. Fuchs has the ball now. Fuchs driving to get Murphy and all. Inside, lays it up, no good, and gets his own rebound, dishes it back outside to Cornelia, to Elliott, who tries one for 3 points, and it's called on the lights tonight. Fuchs has the ball now for the Bulldogs, out to Elliott. He tries another one from 3 points and scores again. So Jeff Elliott, they're trying to get the inbounds pass. They finally get into Sullivan, and he stuffs it, and the Bulldogs are on Lynn, who almost loses it, now gets control of it, and Tucker just about called on the foul, but gets away with one there. Cornelia quickly down across the timeline with a great pass to Kevin England and the Bulldog. Cornelia, Fuchs has the ball now way outside, trying to get it inside. He's dribbling around into the corner, finally gets it off to Cornelia. Cornelia inside to Fuchs. Fuchs turnaround jump shot is up and good.
Changed our team. We became a running team after that.
3 points.
Western now advanced into a District 12 semifinal game against Marist College of North Dakota. The Bulldogs jumped out to a 42-31 halftime lead and never looked back, winning 90-76.
Champion, Western Montana Bulldogs keep proving that there's no place like home. Saturday night, the Bulldogs won for the 11th time in 14 games. More importantly, it was a 90-76 victory in the District 12 semifinals. We go to highlights from Western Montana College against Mary University from South Dakota. Western on top, 51-38, second half. Rich Lorenz for the Marauders drives the baseline and scores to pull within 11, but that would be about as close as it would get. Watch 6-6 sophomore Kevin Englund at 20 points on the night. Western, again, on the offense. This is Dave Cornelia feed Mike Van Der Zanden from Oregon. He gets it in and scores. The inside game worked like a charm for Western Montana College, like taking candy from a baby, thanks to some precision passing. That's Roger Fields to Englund. That was a great one. Western Montana coach T.C. Kelch loved it. Now watch Duke product, John Sullivan. Little spin, little fake, and a basket and a foul. 3-point play. 16 points for Sullivan. 90-76. Western wins it. Next up for the Bulldogs, the District 12 Finals Wednesday night in Dillon, where Western will host the Northern State Wolves of Aberdeen, North Dakota. The Wolves won the NIC Conference and then upset Huron 79-75 over the weekend. The winner of that game will move on to the Big 32. And you know we'll have more on Western later.
Bulldogs earned the right to advance to the NAIA National Championships in Kansas City with an 88-66 win over the Northern State Wolves before a packed house at the Stroud Gymnasium. Now, the last time Western made the trip to Kansas City was 20 years ago, which coincidentally is head coach Casey Kelch's first on the Western sideline. Now, let's go to the action in the first half in Dillon. Western will be on the attack. They'll go down low to their money man, Mike Van Der Zanden, for the heap and the foul. The Dogs up four early. Now, Keith Moore always seemed to have the answer for Northern. This guy can flat out shoot the balls. He spots up and drills the triple. Moore leading off scores with 27, but the Dogs still led by 7. Boulder native Jeff Elliott turned in his usual steady performance, matching Moore tray for tray. Elliott with 18, and Western led 32-25 at the break. The Bulldogs put it away midway through the second half on three consecutive baskets by ex-Central star John Sullivan. first on that drive right there. Later, Moore will come down with the lazy pass right there. Sullivan steps in front for the layup at the other end. And coming up in a moment off the steal by Dave Cornelia. The Bulldogs will get the ball out in transition. Cornelia to Sullivan on the break, and boom, the slam dunk and the foul. That put Western up by 13, and it was party time last night in the city of Dillon after that. Just a great game for the Bulldogs, and as I said, they can now pack their bags for Kansas City. It's been a long time coming, but all the wait did was make the win even sweeter. Again, 88-67, the final score. The Bulldogs picked up 24 points from sophomore forward Kevin Englert, along with 18 from Elliott. When it was over, I talked with an excited bunch of Bulldogs.
Well, I think we played really well, Sean, as a team defense today. I thought maybe our defense, pressure defense, kind of took them out of their offense a little bit. And then second half, we tried to mix the man-to-man with the zone, and I think it kind of confused them a little bit.
Oh, it's the best feeling I've ever had in my life.
This is the best. I would have never thought 4 years ago when I came in here that we would have won our last game at Dow Gymnasium, and I just thank God that we won, and hope we do well in Kansas City.
Kennett College Bulldogs made their last appearance at the NAIA National Basketball Championships in Kansas City. But tomorrow, that all changes when the Dogs hook up with defending national champion Grand Canyon College. Now, win or lose, the tournament caps off what's been a tremendous season on the Dillon campus. Thought that when March rolled around, the Western Montana College Bulldogs would be competing for a national championship. Picked to finish no better than third in the Frontier, Western plundered the leg, then with surgical precision cut down Mary College along with Northern State en route to Kansas City. Now, the Bulldogs have been led all season by center Mike Vanderzanden along with sophomore forward Kevin Englert, and both attribute the Dogs' success to teamwork.
Well, you know, I just like to do whatever I need to do. When I'm not scoring, I like to do other things to make my other teammates better. I like to pass
like we have been, and we'll be all right.
The Bulldogs were headed to the national NAIA tourney in Kansas City for the first time since 1969. The reward was a matchup against the top-seeded Grand Canyon Antelopes, who had won the tourney the year before and were coming into the game with a 26-4 record. The Bulldogs, on the other hand, were 18-8 and seeded last among the 32 teams. Casey Kelts' team was a little tentative early, but hung in there, and after the shock of playing at Kemper Arena got out of the way, they played good, leading at halftime 38-35. After the break, the 7,000 fans started cheering for the underdogs, and Western cruised to a 79-65 victory. The first time since 1975 that a top-seeded team was knocked off. Casey Kelts said the key to the game was that his team blocked out and then was very patient on offense. The Bulldogs also hit their free throws down the stretch and ended up the game 28-35. The Dogs also out-rebounded the Antelopes 42-37, with 6'10" Roger Fuchs collecting 9 and John Sullivan and Kevin Englert each grabbing 8. Jeff Elliott led all scorers with 21 points and also contributed with 7 rebounds. The Bulldogs were the talk of the town and were known as a team of flat tops, whose coach is known as the Dean of the Frontier and who looked like a 1955 class photo come to life.
Tournament play tonight. What a great night it was for both. The Lady Grizz advanced to the final 32 of the NCAA Women's Tourney. Western Montana College is in the final 16 of the NAIA. What a shocker tonight in Kansas City. There is no other word to describe what happened in the first round of the NAIA Tourney. The Western Montana College Bulldogs beat the defending national champs, the Dogs, over Grand Canyon of Arizona, 79-65. First half action, inbounds play, Roger Fuchs wide open. How big was this upset? Grand Canyon seeded number one in the nation, Western seeded 32nd. But the Dogs controlled the game. Great ball movement, Mike Vanderzanden ends up with the basket in the paint. Pretty good crowd at Kemper Arena, and as the game progressed, they were solidly behind the underdog Bulldogs.
Another solid game for Kevin England. Two of his 19 on the tough baseline shots. England just so consistent for Western. Give a lot of credit to Coach Casey Kelch. His team wasn't intimidated. They controlled the tempo. Grand Canyon is averaging 98 points a game. This tip and put back by Roger Fuchs pretty much put it away, as you can tell by the celebration of setters on the bench for the Western Montana College Bulldogs. And then as the final second tick down, it was very much the Western Montana College Bulldogs in control against the defending national champ. And when the clock runs out, a well-deserved celebration for the Bulldogs. Now, while you look at some of the details of this game, let's put this into perspective. This is the first time since 1975 that the number one seed in the NAIA National Tournament has lost in the first round. Quite a credit to the Bulldogs, by the way. The Bulldogs.